I have dedicated my professional career to the study and control of arthropods.
Hello, I am out at the Mendenhall Glacier. I'm right near the visitor center here. I found a secluded spot. I had to wade across the stream to get here, trying to avoid having 1,000 tourists in my in the view here. So it's kind of hard. I'm holding this in my hand, so I hope it's not too shaky. I want you to look at that absolutely beautiful sight. That's the Mendenhall Glacier right there. It's a lot better than looking at my ugly mug. So, this, let's see if I can set this aside here. Anyway, this glacier is pretty amazing. It is calving right now. I'll show you. It's not calving at the second, I suppose, but I'm going to turn just slightly here, and hopefully you'll be able to see. I can't look and see if this is actually getting in the shot or not. But those are icebergs. Broke off the glacier. And it's really cool. We come out here in the wintertime when this lake's frozen solid. And we go out and we play on the ice out here. I mean, it's thick. It's like a meter thick or more. And the icebergs that were in there from the previous summer are now like islands in the middle of it. So the kids go up, they can climb up on them and stuff. And it's good Alaska fun. But this is really a neat area. I used to bring, when I was back as an undergraduate, I was a teaching assistant for biology. I know it's unusual, but I was an unusual undergraduate. As a teaching assistant, we bring classes out here, and I'd do a whole glacier tour talking about the succession, because this is a great example of succession here. And I'm going to hopefully, I might actually take some video with my digital camera rather than using the laptop, because I'm a little, I don't want to go tromping around in the streams with my digital camera. I mean, with my laptop. My camera is waterproof, so it doesn't matter if I drop it. It's also impact resistant. Anyway, I want to show some of this, because this is really cool, because this glacier's retreated. I believe it's stable now. I think it's retreating, but it's moving forward, but it's breaking off, so it's kind of staying at the same distance, I believe. I'm not positive about that. I don't keep up on the, glacier gossip. It's a duck. Never mind, there's beavers that swim around here too. The beavers like to go into this lake for some reason. I'm not sure what's in it for beaver. But the glacier here, but as it did do a retreat, it was retreating for about 200 years or so. And as it's been retreating, they've marked off the places as to where it's, at what level it was. And it's really cool because there's actually date markers, 1910, 1922, whatever, as it goes up. You can see where the glacier was at some point in time, the face of the glacier. And you can look at the vegetation, the mosses, the lichens, and then the, the macrophytes, the trees, shrubs, bushes, ground cover. And you can see the succession. So if you get the farther away from the glacier, you start seeing spruce forest. As you get closer and closer to the glacier, you see a lot of cottonwood, for example, willow, cottonwood, the poplar groups, those and then, because you look, I'll show you here, what I'm sitting on is an old glacial moraine, and this is sand. It's just ground up, mostly diorite around here. Not any nutrients in it, not much for things to live off of. So what happens is that the soil gets colonized by ground lichens, a lot of these peltidra, which are nitrogen fixers, so they can live on this sand. And likewise, the rock that's left behind is colonized by other lichens, rock-living lichens, and they start breaking this down. And as they break it down, releasing, they die and decay, they create a small amount of soil. And then some of the plants that come in here, and I'll show some pictures, the pyrola, The wintergreens are one of the groups, as well as some of the other Lobaria lichens and these kinds of things that are also nitrogen fixers and can live in relatively poor soil. And so they build up, and they build up this layer of nutrient-rich soil that then other plants can exploit. Like I said, starting with the willow trees, the alder trees, the cottonwoods and such, and then finally reverting to a spruce forest as you get all the way. It's solid spruce forest as you get past the glacier a little bit, although there's a lot of cottonwood trees out here. So anyway, that's a little brief glacier succession thing, and I think it's really cool because we see a lot of the plants here are the same kinds of things you see up high up if you go up into the Alpine. So even though we're at sea level, it duplicates kind of an Alpine environment. It's that same terrain. The temperature is significantly cold. It's today's up into the upper 60s in Juneau, and here it's actually quite chilly. The wind blowing off that glacier is cold. It actually feels nice. Let's check my time here at 5:55. So I'm going to pack up here and turn on my camera video and start taking some video, and I'll narrate as I go along rather than trying to dub it in later. I hope you guys enjoy. I'll hopefully see some cool things. So, all right. I will back in a sec. One more shot of that big giant ice cube. Just a fun fact, by the way, before I go. That thing is, the ice sheet that it's a part of is actually almost twice the size of the state of Rhode Island. So, it's pretty cool. Big ice cube.